Hello guys, welcome back once again. This is Jagrat here, and previously we have already seen that how to set up the TestNG in Eclipse IDE. Okay, and I've already told you the brief introduction regarding the TestNG. Okay, so in the today's session I will cover the basic annotations that are generally used in TestNG. Okay, I will tell you that what are the execution orders of those, you know, annotations. Okay guys, so let's start. Firstly, let me create a proper package. Okay, so let me create a package. Let us suppose my package name is com.testngtest. Okay, let us suppose this is my package. So just click on finish. So you can see that package is created. Now inside this package, I will create a proper class. Okay, and let us suppose my class name is annotations. Okay, let us suppose my class name is annotation test. Okay. Guys, always remember, when you will create a TestNG class, okay, there will be no main method. Okay, please remember this thing. You don't have to click on this public static void main. Okay, just click finish. Just give the class name and then just click on finish. Okay, so guys, there are three types of annotations. Okay, so first is the pre-annotations. Let me firstly write for you guys. So pre-annotations. Okay. Second is test case related annotations. I will tell you. Okay. Don't worry about that. And third is post annotations. Okay, so basically three types of annotations are there. Okay, so I will tell you one by one that what are the pre-annotations, what are the test case related annotations, what are the post annotations. Okay, so let me give you the some real life example. Let us suppose if you want to automate any particular site, okay, any particular web page, then firstly you need to, you know, set up the environment and launch the URL. Okay, so these are the prerequisite conditions. Okay, because without opening the URL, without set up the environment, you cannot automate any particular web page. Okay, so those conditions comes will definitely come under the pre-annotations. Okay, and whatever the test cases that you will write, that will come under the test case related annotations. Okay, and after you know, running your script, you should close your URL. Okay, or if you have the database connection, then you should close your database connection. Okay, so that comes under the post annotations. Okay, now how can we define the annotations? Okay, so I will tell you one by one. Like firstly, I will tell you the pre annotations, then test case, then post annotation. So in this session, you at the end of this session, you will see that how can we define the annotations. Okay, what are the structure, okay, that in the future I will you know use for our designing our scripts. Okay, so first annotation, pre-annotation, is @. Always remember guys, annotation will start from @. Okay, and the first is before suit. Okay, so this is the first annotation, before suit. Okay, and second thing you need to remember that every annotation is attached with some method. Okay, always remember this thing guys. These are the very basic steps that you should know. So let us suppose I'm not going to write any script. Okay, so before suit, let us suppose this method is there. Okay, and here I am printing like before suit method. Okay, before suit method. Okay, so step by step we will proceed. So firstly, in this session you need to understand that how can we define the different types of annotations and what are the execution, what is the execution order. Okay, so you can see that this is the before suit annotation. Okay, these all are, let me write here, these all are precondition annotations. Okay, or we can say pre annotations. Now the second annotation is @ before test. Okay, the second annotation is @ before test. Okay, and let me copy this and let me paste here. So this is before test. Let me change the name. Okay, and this is before test method. Okay, so this is the second type of annotation. Third type of annotation is @ before class. Okay, see, @ before class, and here I will write before class method. Guys, always remember, every annotation is attached with one method. Okay, always remember this thing. So this is before class method. Okay, now next thing, @ last. So before method. Okay, so this is before method annotation. So let me write this before method annotation. Okay, so this is before method. So guys, these are the, you know, important pre annotations. So first is the before suit, second is the before test, third before class, and fourth before method. Okay, now these are the pre annotations. Now I am going to tell you test related annotation. Okay, so what is the test related annotation? So for that purpose, @ test will be used. Okay, and here I will write the method before, public void, let us suppose test method is used. Okay, so this is the test method. Let me write that. Okay, and what is the, okay, so we need to import it, org.testng.annotations. Okay, so this is the only one which comes under the test related annotation. Here we will write our test script. Okay, so I have already told you, in the pre annotations we will set up all environment, we will, you know, write the code for launching the URL. All the prerequisite things will be covered in pre annotation. All your test scripts, all your main tasks will cover under test related annotations. And the third is post annotation. Okay, third is post annotation. So what are the different types of post annotation? So see guys, when I wrote the pre annotations, then firstly I will write before suit, then before test, then before class, then before method. Okay, now here I will follow the reverse order, like after method, after class, after test, and after suit. Okay, so after, you can see, firstly I will write after method. Okay, and let me write here after method. After method, I am writing like this guys because you can easily understand that what are the different types of annotations and what is the execution order. Okay, because guys, they might be asked at the time of interview that what is the execution order for the annotations. Okay, you should know about that. So this is after method. Okay, next is after class. So at the rate after class. Okay, so let me change this after class. So this is after class method. Okay, now the next thing is at the rate after test. Okay, after test, this method will be used. So let me write like this properly, after test. Okay, so let me change this after test. So this is after test method, after test method. Okay, and at the last, at the rate after, which method is used, I mean which particular annotation will be used? Suit. Okay, and this is after suit. Okay guys, so these are the complete list of annotations. There are other annotations for other purpose. Okay, I will tell you in the further sessions, but these are the basic structure for the, you know, this TestNG framework. Okay, so let me run this and let's see the output. Okay, then I will do some variations in this output. Okay, so if you want to run this, then just right click and run as TestNG test. Okay, if TestNG is properly installed in your system, in your Eclipse IDE, okay, then this option will automatically come. Okay guys, so just right click on it and just click on TestNG test. Okay, so guys, you can see here, see, now the output is very clear. Okay, default test, okay, total run 1, failure 0, skip 0. Okay, it means all are passed. Okay guys, there is one test case and that test case is pass. Okay, and what is the order? See guys, before suit, before test method, before class method, before method, okay, then test method, after method, like this. Okay, and after suit method. Okay, so now let's clear this thing, that if they might, they can ask at the time of interview that what is the execution order of the annotations, then you should tell in the first number before suit, then second before test, then third before class, then fourth before method. Okay, then at the rate test, then after method, after class, after test, and after suit. Okay guys, so this is the execution order. Please note down this order. Okay, so this was the first thing. Now the second thing is, okay, so just one more thing before proceeding. If you want to see the output, okay, so you can see the output here. Okay, you can see the output in this console also. I already showed you, like, see the output, total run 1, failure 0, skip 0. Okay, but I've already told you that TestNG has a very good feature that it will give us the default reporting. Okay, so if you want to see the default reporting of TestNG, just right click on this project, okay, and just refresh it. So guys, you can see there are only three folder here, SRC, TestNG and reference library. Okay, now when you will refresh that after running the script, there will be the another folder called test output folder. See guys, test output folder. Okay, and when you will expand this, then you have to pick this index.html file, just right click and go to the properties, okay, and copy this path. Okay, copy this path and go to the Chrome. Okay, so let me show you the default reporting of TestNG feature. So let me open the Chrome. Okay, so let's wait and watch. Yes, okay, just paste that URL here, okay, and press enter. So as soon as you will press enter, you will see the proper output of TestNG. Okay, so you will see the output. Just wait. I think Chrome is hanged in my system, so we have to wait. See guys, this is the test result for your last run. Okay, so you can see here past method. If you will click on show, so see, one test is passed. Okay, one method, one passed. Okay, and this is the chronological order. Before suit, before test, before class, before method, then test, after method, after class, after test, and then after suit. Okay, so you can verify the order from here also. Okay, then if you want to know the how much time it will take to run, so you can see that 13 milliseconds it took to run. Okay, and one test is there, that is the default test. So you can see this type of output, okay, and you can send this particular report to your manager that yes, I ran any particular test cases and this is the result. Okay guys, so you can work like this. Now let us suppose if anyone asks from you that how many test cases are there, okay, in this particular framework, how many test cases are there? So guys, there is only one test case. There is only one test case. Okay, so if anyone asks that how many test cases are there, so just see in your script that, you know, how many @ test notations are there. Okay, here we have only one test notation, so only one test case is there. Okay, now let us suppose guys, I am just going to copy this. Okay, this is my second test case, this is my third test case. Okay, so let us suppose this is one, so test one method. Okay, this is two, so test two method, and this is three, so this is test three method. Okay guys, now how many test cases are there? Three test cases are there, because three times @ test I will write. I am writing. Okay. Now guys, always remember, before method, @ test, and after method will be paired for each iteration. Okay. Let me clear this thing. Okay. Always remember guys, this before method, this test method, this test annotation and this post annotation will be executed always in pair. Okay, so as I told you, what was the chronological order? Before suit, before test, before class, before method, test, after method, and like this. So these three will always be executed in pair. Okay, let us suppose in future I define one more test case. Okay, so what will be the order? before suit, before test, before class, before method, test 1, after method, before method, test 2, after method, and then after class, after test, after suit. So you can see that before method, test, and after method will be paired, always will be paired. Okay, so let me create more test cases like this. Okay, now let's run this and let's see the output. These are the very basic thing you should know about that, because if you are a fresher or if you are experienced, they might be asked at the time of interview. Okay, so I am again running this and let's see the output. Okay, see guys, see the report. How many test cases are there? 3 test cases are there. Okay, now let's understand the output for this. See guys, before method, before test, before class. Okay, now see this. This is paired. Okay, before method, test 1 method, after method. Then again, before method, test 2 method, after method. Then again, before method, test 3 and after method. Okay guys, so always remember this thing, that before method, then before method annotation, test annotation, and after method annotation always be executed in pair. Okay, now again, if you want to see the output of this, again you need to refresh. So let me refresh this. Okay, and just refresh this. Okay guys, so now you can see how many methods are there. 3 methods, 3 pass. And if you will click on show, then see. Okay, now see the chronological view. Before method, test 1, after method, before method, test 2, after method, before method, test 3, after method. Okay, so this is the chronological view. If you want to see the time, see, first test case is run in 13 milliseconds, then next 6 milliseconds, and then 1 millisecond. Okay guys, so these are the some basic stuffs regarding the TestNG. In this session I am not going to write any script. Okay, so firstly, that is my main motto, that firstly I will tell you all the basic things regarding the TestNG so that your basics will be strong, and then I will move towards the framework building part. Okay, like how to write our real time test cases. Okay guys, so please practice this, and in the next session I will tell you the another important features of TestNG, like how to prioritize the test case. Okay, how to make a group of the test cases, how can we make the dependency among the test cases. Okay, so all these things. But in this session, I already told you the structure of TestNG. Okay, execution order of the annotations and default reporting part. Okay, so guys, if you really like this session, then please like, share and subscribe. So see you in the next session. Bye bye.